Hi, Ian here from Insightful Products. I was watching the Mythbusters last night with my son, and I realized that the type of science that is done in Mythbusters is kind of what we do in clinical practice. That is, it doesn't have the rigorous p-values and statistical analysis that you normally see in science, but you get a reasonable conclusion based on a few studies and kind of casework that allows you to make conclusions to help your patients. So with that disclaimer, what I'm going to show you today is an opinion based on what I see as a practitioner. So for drop foot, a lot of practitioners are using this type of design. This type of design does work for clearance during swing phase and provides a reasonable amount of solution. But it's really not designed for drop foot. If you think about it, this rigid anterior tibial section is really designed for weak plantar flexors. And the problem you have with drop foot is weak dorsiflexors. Why is this for weak plantar flexors? Well, the anterior section loads or controls the forward progression of the tibia through the lever arm and the anterior lever arm of the bottom of the brace. And so that's really what this is meant to do, and that is it's meant to store energy during mid-stance and push the patient off at the end of stance phase. You take a look at how much this AFO here provides in terms of anterior support. You can see that a lot of deflection is made even with just, you know, 12, 13 pounds of pressure, and obviously the typical person would be 100, 200 pounds maybe. Dorsiflexors are what patients are missing when they have drop foot. So the dorsiflexion motion is this, where the foot comes up. And so you need the dorsiflexors for two things. One is when you first hit the ground, you need that muscle group to decelerate the foot and to bring it into plantar flexion. But then you also need those dorsiflexors to bring the foot up at an angle so you can clear the ground, so you don't trip on it. Our design is specifically designed for drop foot and addresses and controls only the parts of the deficit that you need to control. So this design is specifically designed for weak dorsiflexors. What do I mean? Well, the dorsiflexors are what bring your foot up. And that's what provides both clearance and shock absorption during heel strike. So our design has a posterior section for weak dorsiflexors. It does not have a rigid anterior tibial section because for drop foot, you don't need it. And it's not desired. Why? Because this is approaching the problem from the back. And that makes up for the weakness of the muscles in the front. So, the muscles in the front here are not operating, so this replaces that by decelerating the foot at heel strike and then bringing up the foot for clearance during swing phase.